Welcome guys, it's your registered nurse OV. In this video, we'll be talking on the cardiac cycle. Talking about the cardiac cycle simply refers to the cyclical activities that are caused within the heart. Now, these activities that are caused within the heart can be divided into two, which are the systole and the diastole. Systole simply means, systole represents contraction, while diastole represents repolarization or relaxation. So talking about the contraction now, contraction also refers to the word depolarization, while relaxation is also, that also means what? Repolarization, that is relaxation of the heart. The systole is of two types. We have the atrial systole and the ventricular systole. That's the atrial systole and ventricular systole. Now, in order to explain these cyclical activities that occur within the heart, we'll make reference to our ECG representation, that is the graphical representation of electrical activities within the heart. Now, take note of this diagram here, which we'll use for our explanation. This is a sketch of the ECG, where we have the P wave, the QRS complex, and the T wave. So take note of that. So using this diagram, we would also make a sketch of a cycle to represent the cyclical activities that occur within the heart during our explanation. Now, talking about the atrial systole or atrial contraction, the atrial systole simply refers to the contraction of the atrium. Remember, we said it is caused by the transmission of impulse from the SA node for a normal heart. So the atrial systole now starts from a contraction, that's from the transmission of impulse from the SA node, and it causes a contraction of the atrium. Then the next which we'll talk about now is the ventricular systole. Ventricular systole simply refers to ventricular contraction, and it is due to the impulse that has been transmitted from the AV node to the other contracting fibers down to the Purkinje fibers, which causes contraction of the ventricle. So this is the next part of the cycle over here. Over here is the next part of the cycle, right here. So this is it. And lastly now, the next which we'll talk about now is the diastole. Remember, diastole refers to the word relaxation or repolarization. So a relaxation of the heart will take time, enough time for the heart to relax so that blood can flow back into it. So this is usually the largest of the cardiac cycle. So immediately after the heart relaxes, after it's a complete period of relaxation, it goes back again and starts this activity all over. At least contraction, and relaxation. Contraction, and relaxation. Now, talking about the diastole. Diastole simply refers to a complete relaxation of the cardiac muscles. So it can also be referred to as what? A complete cardiac diastole. That's both relaxation of both the atrium and the atrium and the ventricles. So that's what happens in diastole. Now, taking an heart rate of about 75 beats per minute, a cardiac cycle will take about 0.8 seconds for one cycle to be completed, which means from what we said about our electrocardiogram, the atrial contraction, that is the atrial systole, takes about 0.1 seconds to occur, while the ventricular systole takes up to 0.3 seconds to occur. And lastly, the relaxation of the cardiac muscle will take enough time for it to refill again, to be filled again, for each chambers of the atrium to be filled with blood. So this one usually takes a longer time of about 0.4 seconds. So this is a time range for each of the cyclical activities to occur. And this will bring us to the end of the cardiac cycle. Do well to subscribe to our channel so you'll be notified whenever a new video is done.